Hey Fox, we just living our life, right?
Four and three and two and one.
Just play.
Everybody, let's get drunk. Myself, they call me Mr. Fox. Known for making ladies scream and jump for nothing socks. Yes, it's all real. I'm king of the hill. Call Clark Davis, pack him up and ship another man. Told you last time, but I swear y'all must not understand me. Girl, come home with me. Let me introduce you to my Grammy family. Like Uncle Oscar, Aunt Emmy, accolades I got any. Got that kind of rock, you got a willing with a semi, baby. Get your friends and slide with me. Come on, girl, just ride with me. Plenty of girls that wish they could be standing on the side of me. I can see the look up in your eyes, but the looking at your thighs, lips and hips making nature rise. Girl, the cash rules, then my queen is rising to the top. Tonic highway robbery, we doing 90 in the drop. Let's go hit the strip, baby, then go home and strip, baby. Bounce it like them drums on this jazz play, shoot, baby. Girl, to say the word, we could break out like the pox. But you got 4 seconds before I'm right about the spot, like
4 and 3 and 2 and 1. We're here behind the scenes at your cover shoot for the upcoming Uptown issue, and the theme of the shoot, which was easy with you, is the triple threat. The musician, the actor, the comedian. And so I wanted to know just from you, which setup was your favorite?
I think the music was the most fulfilling, because that's what we're on right now. The music is what I've always wanted to do, like when I first started out. Then I ended up coming to LA and becoming the most famous, one of the most famous transvestites. in the Wanda character, hey, for real though, which really wasn't my dream. It was a weird doorway to get through, to get back to the music. But of course, you know, you've been hanging out at the shoot, so every aspect of it has that comedy sort of in the back of it. So the comedy thing is what, you know, I feel sometimes most comfortable.
You see the rock, man?
Oh, yeah.
That's the only thing I ain't black about.
Because you seem very natural in all three, I wonder if you had to just choose one craft.
Ooh, I think I would stay with the music.
Okay.
The reason being is because as we were listening to George Benson, and we had played all the songs, including my music, and you hear George Benson come on Broadway, Masquerade, and those types of things. A joke will get old, movies will start to look old or whatever, but music will forever have its youth, you know, especially if you're lucky enough to get not just a hit song, but a song that really speaks to you. Like right now, what I'm afraid of, what we're all afraid of as artists is doing a song that's great for the masses and it sells, but it doesn't have that Masquerade and that On Broadway or some of those songs that'll really last. So music is the ultimate, because it challenges you to try to find where you match the popularity of the time and the history and the vintageness of the music.
Your album, the album that is out right now, certainly has some hits for the club and then some hits that you can feel the longevity in their classics. Yeah. So we were talking before about the video for Blame It tonight, and all the people who were in the video and sort of how you got those people to come on board.
We were at the inaugural watching Mr. Barack Obama, President Barack Obama, Mr. President, do his thing. If there's any indication that America is not the most incredible country in the world, watching Mr. Obama do his thing, and Ron Howard was there. I asked Ron Howard, would you be in the music video? He said yes. So I leveraged that and said, Mr. Whitaker, would you be in it? And then on to Samuel Jackson and Quincy Jones and Jake Gyllenhaal, a host of people, as you see in the video. That's when it really works. That's when it really feels good. Because you look at say, like the Rat Pack with Dean and Sammy and those guys and Frank Sinatra, they always did things together. So this was an opportunity to sort of go old Hollywood, old music. The song is young and vibrant, but I wanted to bring the classiness with it. So it would have, you know, it would have some legs, some longevity. And then the most important part of the video was my sister who has Down syndrome. Jamie, please let me, please, bro, let me be in the video. So we put her in the video, beautiful shots of her, and she called me. I couldn't even understand what she was saying. She was so happy on the phone. She got a ponytail in, all that. So she's on fire right now. Shout out to DeAndra Dixon. She's on fire.
Thanks for your time.
Thank you.